ശുക്രതുണ്ടമഹാകായ സൂര്യകോടിസമപ്രഭ നിർവിഘ്നം കുരു മേ ദേവ സർവകാര്യേഷു സർവദാ സരസ്വതി നമസ്തുഭ്യം വരദേ കാമരൂപിണി വിദ്യാരംഭം കരിഷ്യാമി സിദ്ധിർഭവതു മേ സദാ ഗുരവേ സർവലോകാനാം ഭിഷജേ ഭവരോഗിനാം നിധയേ സർവവിദ്യാനാം ദക്ഷിണാമൂർത്തയേ നമഃ ഈശ്വരോ ഗുരുരാത്മേതി മൂർത്തിഭേദവിഭാഗിനേ വ്യോമവത് വ്യാപ്തദേഹായ ദക്ഷിണാമൂർത്തയേ നമഃ സദാശിവസമാരംഭാം ശങ്കരാചാര്യമധ്യമാം അസ്മദാചാര്യപര്യന്താം വന്ദേ ഗുരുപരമ്പരാം ശ്രുതിസ്മൃതിപുരാണാനാം ആലയം കരുണാലയം നമാമി ഭഗവത്പാദം ശങ്കരം ലോകശങ്കരം സാക്ഷാത് കൃതം ദയാനന്ദം പരമാർത്ഥസ്വരൂപിണം തത്വജ്ഞാനപ്രശാസ്താരം പ്രണതോസ്മി പരം പദം. ഓം സഹനാഭവതു സഹനോ ഭുനക്തു സഹവീര്യം കരവാവഹൈ തേജസ്വിനാവധേതമസ്തു മാ വിദ്വിഷാവഹൈ. ഓം ശാന്തി ശാന്തി ശാന്തിഃ. ഓം നമോ ഭഗവതേ വൈവസ്വതായ മൃത്യവേ ബ്രഹ്മവിദ്യാചാര്യായ നചികേതസേ ച. We can chant the mantra. അന്യത്ര ധർമാത് അന്യത്ര ധർമാത്
അന്യത്ര ധർമാത് അന്യത്ര ധർമാത്
അന്യത്ര ധർമാത് അന്യത്ര അധർമാത്
അധർമാത്
അന്യത്ര ധർമാത് അന്യത്ര അധർമാത്
അന്യത്ര ധർമാത് അന്യത്ര അധർമാത്
അന്യത്രാസ്മാത് കൃതാ കൃതാത് അന്യത്ര ഭൂതാച്ച ഭവ്യാച്ച
അന്യത്ര ഭൂതാച്ച
യത്തത് പശ്യസി തദ്വദ സർവേ വേദാ യത് പരമാമനന്തി
സർവേ വേദാ യത്
പരമാമനന്തി
തപാംസി സർവാണി ച യത് വദന്തി
തപാംസി സർവാണി ച യത് വദന്തി
യദിച്ഛന്തോ ബ്രഹ്മചര്യം ചരന്തി
യദിച്ഛന്തോ ബ്രഹ്മചര്യം ചരന്തി
തത്തേ പദം സംഗ്രഹേണ ബ്രവീമി
തത്തേ പദം സംഗ്രഹേണ
ബ്രവീമി
ഓമിതി ഏതത്
ഓമിതി ഏതത്
The 14th mantra is a question asked by Nachiketa. He asked, I want to know that, you please tell me that, which is धर्मात् अन्यत् अधर्मात् अन्यत् कृतात् अन्यत् अकृतात् अन्यत् एंड दैट इज नॉट विदिन द लिमिट्स ऑफ टाइम भूता च भव्या च वर्तमाना च अपि अन्यत् त्रिकालत्रये अपि एतत् तिष्ठति तत् सत्यं तत् तत् सत्यवस्तु यू प्लीज टेल मी That's what is the question even in the first chap, first section. The same question he asked here. The same question he presented in a different form. And the question, by the question we can infer that Nachiketa, he had heard and knows something about Devastu, but is not clear. Dharma tanyata, dharma tanyata. So you want to know it in, know it very clearly from Yamadamba Raja in the form of Upadesha. Therefore, he presents the same question. Astiva nastiva. Kejita asti iti vadati. Kejita nasti iti vadati. And that satyavastu which happens to be which happens to be the subject matter of the Vedas, and that cannot be known by oneself. That has to be learnt from the teacher. And since I have come to you, that is what I want to know. That is the third boon. You please tell me the same question he presents. Then Yamadharma Raja, he starts his teaching from the 15th shloka. Sarve Veda Yat Padam Amanti. The subject matter of the Veda is what revealed by the Shabda. What is the Shabda? Om Iti Etat Sarve Veda Yat Padam Amananti Pratipadayanti. What the Veda reveals, Sarve Veda, all the Vedas. Veda is all the Vedanta here, all the Upanishads, what they reveal is represented by Om, by the Shabda Om. The goal, that is the padam, padyate iti padam, that is to be reached, that is to be attained. Padyate iti padam, that padam, yat padam, Vedaha, Sarve Vedaha, Pratipadayanti, Amananti, Tat Agam Sangrahena Navimi. That I tell you briefly, clearly. So it means here, by saying Sarve Vedaha, another point also is made very clear. That is all the Vedas. They have the same Tatparyam. They have the commitment in revealing only that Ekavastu Brahma, Atma. There are so many Vedas, so many, there are four Vedas and many Upanishads are there. Are they revealing different things? No. They reveal the same Vastu. That is why in Brahma Sutra also we have a Sutra, Tattu Samanvayat. The Vedas, they have the commitment in revealing same Brahma, the Tatparyam of all the Veda is only in revealing the Ekavastu, that Vastu Brahma. And that, for attaining that, the Vedas, they prescribe Tapamsi Sarvanicha Yat Vadanti. They prescribe Tapas. Why do we need tapas? To study Vedanta, a certain preparation is required. And that preparation is provided by the Vedas itself. Certain kama, certain desires, certain desires, intense desires, which needs to be fulfilled. For that, the means are given. Certain desires you can analyze and you can just drop. Certain desires you can fulfill by your own effort. Certain desires which cannot be fulfilled by the ordinary means, you take the support of the Vedas. Karmakanda prescribe certain rituals, doing which the certain desires which you are keeping with Dharma can be fulfilled. And also, it prescribes certain tapas. See, fulfilling the desire is to get a relative contentment to pursue Vedanta. That is why the fulfillment of the desires is also important. We never condemn desires. Kama we don't condemn. Dharma aviruddhaka kamaha we don't condemn at all. Kama is a privilege. Desire is a privilege given by Bhagavan. But only human being can have the privilege to desire. Have the privilege, desire to know, desire to gain. And the desire should be in keeping with Dharma. And the desire should be a non-binding desire. So therefore, all the Vedas prescribe various karma. Kayika karma, vachika karma, manasa karma. Many meditations are also prescribed. In addition to that, certain tapas are also prescribed. Tapas is involuntarily taking up certain vrata, involuntarily accepting certain discomfort, denial, self-denial, that is called tapas. So that gives a certain preparedness, certain mental attitude towards the gaining of the vastu, the Brahma. You need certain preparedness. Therefore, tapas also important. That tapas can be either kayika, arvachika, or manasa. So therefore, all the Vedas which they reveal, sabhi vedaha amananti pratipadayanti, and to attain the Vedas which prescribed the tapas, For gaining what? For the gaining of Brahma. Yet ichanti brahmacharyam taranti. Brahmacharyam is also a tapas. Brahmacharya, the commitment to know Brahma, that is also a tapas. As I said before, brahmacharya, if you can take literally the meaning of brahmacharya, it could be leading the life of a celibate. It is a brahmacharya. Or it could be, brahmacharya can be taking, studying Veda. Brahmachari is the student. One who studies Vedanta is called a Brahmachari. He can be a Grihastha also, but he studies Shastram for moksha, for gaining Brahma, for gaining knowledge. Therefore, he is still a Brahmachari. Though he is a Grihastha, but still he can be called a Brahmachari. So, Brahmani Charati. The Brahmachari. The one who revels in Brahma is also Brahmachari. And for gaining Brahma, one leads a certain lifestyle. That is, he is also called a Brahmachari. And taking exclusively a particular lifestyle to know Brahma, that is a Naishtika Brahmacharya. The person takes the particular lifestyle. He doesn't take sannyasa, he doesn't marry also. That is an aishtika brahmacharya. Another brahmacharya is married. He gets married. After Gurukula Vasa, he marries. But he continues to pursue Brahma. That is another type of brahmacharya. Upakurvana brahmacharya. So, Naishtika Brahmacharya is there. Another one, though he is in Grihastha Ashrama, but still he continues to pursue this Purushartha. That is another Brahmacharya. So, therefore, Yat ichchantah brahmacharyam charanti. Desiring that, those they take up this lifestyle of brahmachari, brahmacharyam charanti. Then tat padam Dattapadam Sankaragena Bravimi. Tattpada, I will tell you briefly. What is that Tattpadam? Tattpadam is Om. Tattpadam, Om iti etat. Yamadharmaraja simply said Om. Briefly he said, this is too brief, Om iti etat. And this Om is what is Dharmat anyat, Adharmat anyat. Kritat anyat, Akritat anyat. Kalatrayepi teshtati iti Om. And Om is not different from Brahma. It is not different from Brahma. So that is the Atma Tattva. Om is the Atma Tattva. It is the it's a word. It's a Shabda. Om is the Shabda. As a Shabda, it is available for inquiry. As a Shabda, it is available for inquiry for the spiritual seekers, spiritual aspirants. Shabda means it is a word, Varnatmaka, made of Varna, letters, syllables. Varnatmaka, it is Shabda. A, E, U. Made of three letters, which is Om. That Om represents Brahma. It's a Om Shabda is a highly loaded Shabda. It needs to be inquired. Brahma vichara kartavya, Omkara vichara kartavya. As Brahma is to be inquired by studying the Shastra, similarly the Om is also inquired, because Om is not different from Brahma. So, as the Shabda, it is available for inquiry. Therefore, Varnatmaka Shabda Rupena Om, and that Om is Vichara Kartavyaha, Omkar Vichara Kartavyaha. Then same Om, it is available as a Pratika. It is available as a Pratika. Pratika is a symbol. Like we have a Shivalinga. Shivalinga is a Pratima. Linga is a Pratima. On that Linga, we superimpose Bhagavan Shiva. Mahadeva is superimposed on the Linga. So as Shivalinga is Aropita, as Shiva is Aropita on the Linga, as Vishnu is Aropita in the Shaligrama, similarly, the Omkara also, it is Aropita. Omkara is also, is Aropita. Omkara is taken as the Alambana. Like the Shivlinga is taken as the Alambana for Puja, for Upasana, like Shaligrama is taken as the Alambana, as support for Upasana. Similarly, the sound symbol, those are Murtis. They are physical objects, physical Murti. And this is a sound symbol. Dvaniyatmaka. Dvaniyatmaka Pratikam. So that's why it's called Pratikam. As a Pratika, it can be taken as the Alambana for meditation. For meditation on Brahma. It is Upasana. One is Upasana, other one is Jnanam. What is revealed by the Shabda Om? Shabda Vachya. Vachya is Uchyate Iti Vachya. What is revealed by the Shabda Om? That inquiry is Jnana. And meditating on the Shabda as a Pratika, that is Upasa. Both are different. As the Shabda, it is available for inquiry. That is for knowing the Brahma. As a pratika, it is available for meditation. Both are different. One is jnana and other one is upasana. One is para, other one is apara. Therefore, what will be the palam? The palam has to be different. As shabdavacha, it is available for the mumukshus to inquire. As a pratika, it is available for certain people, upasakas, for upasana. So, if om as is taken as a pratika for upasana, like linga is taken as a pratima for upasana, it has certain palam, and the palam is brahmaloka prapti. Brahmaloka prapti is the palam. If you read any Sahasranamam or any stotram, if you read Shiva stotram, you will find at the end Shiva loke magiyate. If you read any Vishnu slokam or Vishnu sahasram, Vishnu like Vishnu loke magiyate, he goes to Vishnu loka, he goes to Shiva loka. Similarly, here Omkara Upasana also gives the palam Brahma loka, it is going to Brahma loka. Brahma loka, loka is a field of experience, therefore it is limited. Loka is such a field of experience. But maybe the instrument available for experience may be different. As we have Shabda, Sparsha, Rupa, Rasa, Gandha as the five elements are there, five tattvas are there, and five sense organs are there available for the experience. Similarly, there are different field of experience. In Brahma Loka, Brahmaji will be there. Brahmaji will give the Brahma Upadesha. Again, he will teach the same Shastram. And there he gains Jnanam and therefore Mukti. Moksha he gets. That is called Krama Mukti. So, taking Omkara as the Alambana and doing Upasana, the palam is going to Brahma Loka, Brahma Loka Prapti, and the Mukti, and gaining Mukti. That Mukti is called Krama Mukti. And doing vichara, om shabda vachya vichara. Vichara, by that, a person gains Brahma here itself. Igaiva, igaiva eva, iga eva. That is sadhyo mukti. That is sadhyo mukti. So therefore, omkara can be taken in as upasana, as a pratika, it can be taken as upasana, as a vacha, it can be inquired. Now that Yamadharma Raja, he introduced, he said, om. Then further, in the next few shlokas we will be seeing, we will be talking about the om. And we have discussed this mantra, the mantra number 15 in the detail in the previous class. Now we will see the mantra number 16. Etadhyevaksharam Brahma.
Etadhyevaksharam Brahma.
Etadhyevaksharam Param.
Etadhyevaksharam Param.
Etadhyevaksharam jnatva.
Etadhyevaksharam jnatva.
Yo yadichyati tasya tat.
Yo yadichyati tasya tat.
Okay, we will see this mantra now. So, om as a vachaka, as a sub, as a word. It can be looked upon as a word. And om can be looked upon as a pratika. As the word, it is used for the analyzing Brahma, Atma. And Mandukya Upanishad, as I said before, it clearly describes the three letters of the om. The three letters is the adhyaropa. When you say om, the after between the two om, 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 the three letters a, u, ma, that is o, om, and followed by the silence. So the three letters are the adhyaropa of the upadesha. We know adhyaropa apavadabhyam nishprapancham prapanchate. First we do the adhyaropa, then we negate it. Same thing is done in the omkara also. But from the silence, om, the sound comes. Again it merges in the silence. Again, so adhyaropa, the prapancha, the srishti comes from the Brahma, and again merges back to the Brahma. Mayyeva sakalam jatam, mayi sarvam pratishtitam, mayi sarvam layam yanti. In Kaivalya Upanishad it comes. It mayyeva sakalam jatam. In from me only everything is created. Sakalam jatam, mayi eva. Mayi is what? Brahma. I am not different from Brahma. So mayyeva sakalam jatam, mayi sarvam pratishtitam. In me alone everything is supported. Brahmani, eva, in Brahma alone everything is supported. Then everything resolves back in me alone. So who is me then? Agam Brahma Asmi. That is the Upadesha. And that same thing is the Tatparya of Om also is the same. That letter, three letters are the Adhyaropa part of the Upadesha, and the Apavada is done later. The three letters are negated, and the negated what you. The negated after you negate, the following negation, what is revealed is Nirguna Brahma. So that therefore the womb can be inquired upon like this. And also, when you say Om, the first thing is your lip, it is separated. When you say Om, your mouth is wide open. When you say Om, and when you say the last letter, then the mouth is closed, the lips touch back again. So the opening of the mouth and the closing of the mouth. At the opening it starts, and the closing it ends. So between the closing and the end, all the letters, whatever you can imagine, whatever the language, all the letters are contained. Therefore, all the words are nothing but they all have its birth from Om. That is why any word you say, it is not separate from Brahma. It is Brahma. It is Ishvara. That's why in Samskritam also we say, what is the word for pronoun? Sarva Nama. Any Nama is Bhagavan Nama. That is why even in Sahasranama. Sahasranama is that. Sahasra is only a number. Why Sahasra? It could be Koti. Any Nama you take, it is a Nama of Bhagavan. Sahasranama. Ashtotra Shatanama. So that Nama is only a word. The Nama is, and the number is only just for a certain count, 108 or 1008. But how many words are there? There are innumerable words in language, many languages. All the words are nothing but Om. They all come from this basic sound, Om. So that is, therefore, Om is the highly loaded chabda. It can be taken as the alambana of our meditation, and it can be inquired upon. That Om is further described by Yamadharmaraja here. What did he say? First we will see the Padacheda. Etat Dhevaksharam Brahma. Etat. Etat. Etat Dhez. Etat He. The Sandhi happens. Etat. He. Eva. அக்ஷரம் பிரம்ம ஏதத் ஹி ஏவ அக்ஷரம் பரம் ஏதத் ஹி ஏவ அக்ஷரம் ஞாத்வா யஹ யத் இச்சதி தஸ்ய தத் யஹ யத் இச்சதி தஸ்ய தத் ஏதத் அக்ஷரம் ஹி பிரம்ம ஏதத்யேவ அக்ஷரம் பிரம்ம ஏதத் ஹி அக்ஷரம் பிரம்ம ஏதத் அக்ஷரம் அக்ஷரம் இஸ் த சிலபிள் தட் ஓம் ஏதத் அக்ஷரம் திஸ் அக்ஷரா வாட் அக்ஷரா திஸ் ஓங்காரா திஸ் ஓங்காரா விச் கன்சிஸ்ட் ஆஃப் அகார உகார மகார த த்ரீ மாத்ராஸ் ஆர் தர் அகாரா ஸ்டாண்ட்ஸ் ஃபார் தி ஜாகிரத் பிரபஞ்ச ஜாகிரத் அவஸ்தா உகாரா ஸ்டாண்ட்ஸ் ஃபார் தி ஸ்வப்ன அவஸ்தா ஸ்வப்ன பிரபஞ்ச அண்ட் மகாரா ஸ்டாண்ட்ஸ் ஃபார் மகாரா த லாஸ்ட் லெட்டர் ஸ்டாண்ட்ஸ் ஃபார் தி சுஷுப்தி பிரபஞ்ச சுஷுப்தி அவஸ்தா ஸோ த்ரீ அவஸ்தாஸ் ஆர் தேர் அண்ட் த்ரீ அவஸ்தாஸ் வாட் இஸ் தேர் பகவான் இஸ் தேர் அண்ட் தட் இஸ் வாட் இஸ் ரெப்ரசன்ட் பை தி சைலன்ஸ் அண்ட் விச் இஸ் நாட் அ மாத்ரா விச் இஸ் அமாத்ரா So, Amatra stands for the Turiyam Brahma. That which is in all the three, Avastha, three, and which is not conditioned, which is not conditioned, which is free from all the which is free from attributes, and which is there for the, as for it is available, which is there in and through all the experiences, and that is Brahma. And that is the Vichara done in the Mandukya Upanishad. So, and that is the Adhishtana. The Adhishtana is Brahma. Abhideya is Brahma. Abhidana is Om. And that Om, that Aksharam, Etat Eva Aksharam Brahma. This Aksharam Om is Brahma. This Aksharam Om is Param. ஏதத்யேவாக்ஷரம் பிரம்ம ஏதத்யேவாக்ஷரம் பரம் திஸ் அக்ஷரம் இஸ் பிரம்ம அண்ட் திஸ் அக்ஷரம் இஸ் பரம் வை டூ டைம்ஸ் இட் இஸ் கிவன் பிரம்ம அண்ட் பரம் பிரம்ம இஸ் பரம் கேன் வி டேக் லைக் தட் வி வில் சி பகவத் பாதா வில் சே வை இட் இஸ் யூ வில் டிஸ்டிங்விஷ் வி வில் சி வாட் இஸ் Why it is given two times? Etat eva aksharam brahma, that is first sentence. Etat aksharam eva param, that is second sentence. Etat eva aksharam jnatva, yaha yat icchati tasya tat. Yaha yat icchati saha tasya bhava, tasya tat bhavati. The one who desires, whatever one desires, he becomes that. When yaha ஏதத் ஏவ அக்ஷரம் ஞாத்வா knowing this one becomes that. So, what is the first one? ஏதத் ஏவ அக்ஷரம் பிரம்ம ஏதத் அக்ஷரம் ஏவ அபரம் பிரம்ம ஏதத் அக்ஷரம் ஏவ அபரம் பிரம்ம பவதி அபரம் பிரம்ம அப்பறம் மீன்ஸ் நாட் பரம் ந பரம் அப்பறம் சகுண பிரம்ம அப்பறம் பிரம்ம இஸ் சகுண பிரம்ம பிரம்ம வித் தி அட்ரிபியூட்ஸ் சோபாதிக பிரம்ம பிரம்ம வித் தி உபாதி தட் இஸ் கால்ட் தி சகுண பிரம்ம த சேம் பிரம்ம தென் லுக்ட் அப்பான் ஃப்ரம் தி ஸ்டாண்ட் பாயிண்ட் ஆஃப் ஜாகிரத் அவஸ்தா இட் இஸ் கால்ட் விராட் The same Brahma when looked upon from the Svapna Avastha, it is called Hiranyagarbha. When looked upon the Karana Avastha, it is called Ishvara. So Virat, Hiranyagarbha, Ishvara, they are the same Brahma. But they are looked upon from the different standpoints. Jagrat, Svapna, Sushupti, Avastha. So that Aparam Brahma, the Saguna Brahma, But when you say Saguna, it is Sarvajnaha, Sarvashaktivan, all the attributes. It has all the attributes. Saguna Brahma available for meditation. And Etat Aksharam, Aparam Brahma Bhavati, Saguna Brahma Bhavati. Then, Etat Hi Eva Aksharam, Param Brahma Bhavati. Etat Hi Eva Aksharam, the syllable Om, it is Param Brahma. Param is what? Nirguna Brahma. Nirupadika. Nirupadika Chaitanyam. That which is just no Upadi. Which is the Adhishtana for the all the Avastha, for all the Prapancha, for all the experience in all the states. So that Nirguna Brahma, Aparam Brahma, which is free from attributes. Nirgunam Brahma. Brahman, Brahman with attributes is called Saguna Brahma, which is available, which can be taken as Alambana for meditation. And Nirgunam Brahma, that has to be known through vichara, inquiry. Inquiry into the Shabda, Om. So therefore, the Aksharam, Param Brahma Bhavati. The first line is Aparam Brahma, the second line is Param Brahma. First line is Etat I Eva Aksharam Brahma. Second line, Etat Aksharam Param Brahma. Aparam Brahma Saguna, Param Brahma Nirguna. Then, Etat Aksharam Eva Jnatva Yatha Yati Ichati Tasya Tattva Bhavati. So, Jnatva, knowing or meditating on what? Meditating upon this Aksharam, the one who desires, whatever one desires, that the person gains. It means what? Omkara is available as the Shabda, as a Vachaka, is available. And also it is available as the Pratika. So Omkara Vachaka Jnana, that is the knowledge gained from the Omkara, from the inquiry into the Shabda Omkara, Omkara Vachaka Jnana Sadyomukti. So Omkara Vachaka Jnana Sadyomukti, that is the Palam. And Omkara, taking Omkara as a Pratika and doing meditation on that Upasana, you get Kramamukti. The Palam is different. That is why Jnatva could be, for inquiry it is Jnatva. If it is the Param Brahma, then it has to be known. It has to be known, therefore, Jnatva. If it is Aparam Brahma, it is Jnatva, Upasana. Upasanaya Krama Muktihi. Jnanena Sadhyo Muktihi. As a Shabda, it is available for knowledge, for knowing. Therefore, Jnatva can be taken. Jnatva can be taken as the Brahma is to be inquired upon. Brahma is to be inquired upon, as a Shabda it is to be inquired upon. Therefore, by inquiry, what you know, by inquiry what you gain is Param Brahma. As a Pratika, it is to be meditated upon, Dhyatva. So, what is gained is Aparam Brahma. So, therefore, Yada Yata Ichati, Tasya Tat Bhavati. And this is what the meaning of this mantra is. Then the Bhashyakara says, whatever I said now, the same thing Bhashyakara, in whatever Bhashyakara already said, that is what I said. It should be other way. Whatever Bhashyakara has explained, that already I explained when I explained the mantra. We will read the Bhashyam now. Etadhyevaksharam. Okay, this is Bhashya. Etadhyevaksharam.
Etadhyevaksharam.
Brahma.
Brahma.
Aparam.
Aparam.
Etadhyevaksharam.
Etadhyevaksharam.
Paramcha.
Paramcha.
So, Bhagavad Pada clearly said here. Etad hi aksharam brahma aparam. It says aparam brahma. The first sentence is aparam brahma. And etad eva aksharam paramcha. One is saguna brahma, other one is nirguna brahma. Omkara is saguna brahma, as the Pratika, it is Saguna Brahma. As a Vachaka, it is Nirguna Brahma, Param Brahma. Iti. Then, Tayoho I.
Tayoho I.
Pratikam Yetat Aksharam.
Pratikam Yetat Aksharam.
Tayoho I. Pratikam Yetat Aksharam. Tayoho Pratikam. Okay. For Tayoho, for both Sagunam and Nirguna, for Saguna Brahma as well as Nirguna Brahma, this Omkara is the symbol. The term is symbol. As a Varnatmaka, it is available for inquiry. As a Dvanyatmaka, it's available for meditation. Then, Etadhye Vaksharam.
Etadhye Vaksharam.
Jnatva.
Jnatva.
Upasya.
Upasya.
Brahma iti.
Brahma iti.
Yaha yat icchati.
Yaha yat icchati.
Param aparam va.
Param aparam va.
Tasya tat bhavati.
Tasya tat bhavati.
Param chet jnatavyam.
Param chet jnatavyam.
Aparam chet praptavyam.
Aparam chet praptavyam.
This is a nice sentence. Param chet jnatavyam. Aparam chet praptavyam. Okay. Etat hi eva aksharam jnatva. Jnatva. Upasya Brahma iti yaha yata icchati param param vatasya tat bhavati. Jnatva. Jnatva atva upasya. Jnatva is equal to upasya. That is jnatva upasya Brahma iti. We can take it as jnatva is one, upasya is other one. As the Shabda, as the Vachaka, revealing Nirguna Brahma, then Jnatva should be known. Having understood Om, or having done Upasana, Upasya, having done Upasana on the Brahma, Yaha is the person. Whatever he does, either he does the inquiry or does the upasana. Whatever he does. Tasya tattu bhavati. He accomplishes that. He accomplishes ita icchati tattu tasya bhavati. Whatever he desires, that he becomes. What is that? It could be param brahma or aparam brahma. Param is satya mukti. As the vachaka, as om as a shabda, vachaka, Jnatva, knowing that the person gains Sadhyo Mukti, Param Brahma. Or as Upasya Brahma, the person doing Upasana on the Brahma, he gains Aparam Brahma, Brahma Loka Prapti and Krava Mukti. Therefore, Tasya Tattu Bhavati, whatever he desires, and he gets that, he accomplishes that. Tasya Tattu Bhavati. So, Param Chet, if Brahma is the Param, it is Param. Param Chet Jnatavyam. If it is Param, then it is subject matter of knowledge. It is subject matter of knowledge. If it is Param, Nirguna Brahma is a subject matter for knowing. Saguna Brahma is what one has to gain it by action. Upasana is also a karma. Upasana also is karma. Param chet jnatavyam. Aparam chet praptavyam. Brahma is Param. Nirguna Brahma is Param. And that is not available for gaining. Why? That is what you are. It is not something to be gained. It is Siddha Vastu. It's already an accomplished one. Then what is that which prevents from not knowing? Ajnana. Ajnana has to go. Ajnana has to be removed. Ajnana nivrittya jnana prapti. So, ajnanam with regard to myself, the self-doubt with regard to myself, I am insignificant, I am not okay. The self-doubt always is there. I don't have clear knowledge about myself. The self-doubt is there, that is the cause for any dukkham, any misery. And for that, that has to go. That ajnanam with regard to myself has to go. How does it go? It can go only by knowledge. The ajnanam with regard to myself can go only by knowledge, not by accomplishing things or objects. Shastram says, Tata Tvam Asi, you are what you are after through many Purusharthas. Through many Purusharthas, what we are trying to do is to make ourselves complete. Unless we are complete already, nothing can make us complete. Nothing in the world can make us complete. But there is a seeking for completion. Purnatvam is there. Therefore, I must be already complete. Aham Purnaha. That is not known to me. Therefore, since Ajnanam is there, then what could be the solution? Jnanam. Therefore, it is Jnatavyam. Aham Brahma Asmi. That Nirguna Brahma is Jnatavyam. With body, without body, I am Brahma. With body, Saguna. Without body, Nirguna. I am the person. I am Chaitanyam. I am Atma, which is, I am there in all the three states of experience. Jagat or Sushupti. I am in the three periods of time, but I am not limited by any of this because I am Brahma. And that is the subject matter for knowing Param. It is not for gaining by doing something. Nasti akritaha kritena. Kritena karmana nabhavati. By doing karma, it is not accomplished because it is Siddha Vastu. Therefore, Param. Param chet yatavyam. Aparam chet, if it is aparam, opposite of Param is aparam. Aparam could be either any loka or any purushartha, anything to be accomplished in time and place. That is aparam. Saguna Brahma. Here it is Saguna Brahma. Param is Param Brahma. Aparam is Saguna Brahma. Brahma Loka Prapti, that Krama Mukti, that is Aparam. Aparam Chet Praptavyam. Brahma Loka Prapti, by doing Upasana and Brahma, you go to Brahma Loka. When do you go to Brahma Loka? After Maranam, after death. After death, you go to Brahma Loka. You get a special Shariram probably and special Indriya. You go to Brahma and there you do Shravanam, you get Krama Mukti. So it is to be reached. A travel is involved, therefore aparam. Travel is involved, therefore praptavyam. It has to be attained, gained. Gained in time, gained in at a particular place. So param chet nyatavyam, aparam chet praptavyam. It has to be gained in time. That is why when we say param chet nyatavyam, that nyatavyam can be done here itself. Nyatavyam can be done here itself. Why should we go to Brahmaloka to know this same thing, the same fact? Akum Brahma Asmi. Why should we go to the Brahmaloka and know? Why can't be known here itself? That is why this Brahma Vichara is superior to Brahma, Saguna Brahma Upasana. Upasana also is karma, therefore it has limitation. And what you gain by Upasana is Aparam Brahma. And by Jnanam is Param Brahma, and therefore Sadhyo Bhukti Iti. Then the next mantra we will read, and then we will stop today. We'll continue later. Then the 17th mantra. Etadalambanam Sreshtam. Etadalambanam Param. Etadalambanam Yatva. Brahmaloke Mahiyate. So this mantra says alambanam. Alambanam is support. Etat alambanam. Etat alambanam sreshtam. Superior. Etat sreshtam alambanam. This alambana is support is superior. Sreshtam bhavati. Etat alambanam param bhavati. Etat alambanam param. Etat alambanam nyatva. Brahmaloke mahiyate. So this is the, this alambanam. Alambanam is support. Taking Omkara as a support. Taking Omkara as a support either for the vichara or for the meditation, it is considered to be the param. That is why sannyasis, they have only Omkara Upadesha. Doing Gayatri Upasana as a brahmachari, the father initiates a son into Gayatri by uttering the Gayatri mantra secretly into his ear. Gayatri mantra, the 23 or 24 aksharas, which contains the essence of all the Vedas, which Vyahruti, Bhu Bhuvaha Suvaha iti. The same Gayatri mantra is further condensed into Om as the alambana for vichara, for the sannyasi. We say sannyasi give up Gayatri mantra. Yes, they give up the Gayatri mantra, what they have been doing from the state of Brahmacharya. But the same Gayatri, it is condensed in the form of Om. That is the essence of the Vedas, all the Vedas. Om, they don't give up. Om is there. So, in fact, the same Gayatri is there in the form of Om. And that is the Alambanam, Param Alambanam, Sreshtam Alambanam. Etat Alambanam Jnatva, meditating on that, Dhyatva Atva Jnatva, Saha Brahma Loke Mahiyate. Then he becomes Mahiyate. He becomes adorable. Becomes adorable in the Brahma Loka. What does it mean? We have to look into the Bhashya. Then only we will understand what it is. We will do it. We will do it in the next class. So we stop here. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.
धन्यवाद जी
धन्यवाद गुरुजी
थैंक यू
धन्यवाद
थैंक यू सर